Good morning, students. Today, as part of our discussion, we are having the chapter of dissolution. In the earlier chapters of partnership accounts, and we have done change in profit sharing ratio, admission, retirement, and death. That was part of reconstitution of firm, reconstitution of partnership rather, where the relationship between the partners had changed, but the firm continued. Here in this chapter, we will find the dissolution or where we have to discontinue the partnership firm in itself. Now, what is dissolution? Dissolution means breaking up or extinction, that is discontinuance of existing relationship among the partners. Dissolution may be either of partnership or dissolution of partnership firm. What was dissolution of partnership that we did in the earlier chapters? It was the change in the existing relationship between partners, but the firm may continue its business as before. The examples of dissolution of partnership that we did earlier were change in partner existing profit sharing ratio among the partners, admission of a partner, retirement of a partner, death, insolvency, completion of a venture, expiry of period of partnership due for which it was formed. We notice that death of a partner, insolvency, completion of a venture, and expiry of the period of partnership can also come under dissolution of firm. Now, dissolution of firm is different from dissolution of partnership. Now, let's come to what you mean by dissolution of a firm. Here, it means dissolution of partnership and the firm. Now, what are the circumstances under which firm can be dissolved? Here, as the flowchart shows, dissolution of firm can be of two. One is when without the order of court, that comes under section 40 to 43 of the Indian Partnership Act of 1932. The second one is dissolution by court order under section 44. Without the court order, there can be four modes when all the partners agree for the dissolution. Where there is no other means rather than compulsory dissolution, section 41, on happening of a certain contingency under section 42, and by notice by all the partners or one for all under section 43. When all the partners agree, then there is no need for any discussion, the firm is dissolved. But what are the conditions for compulsory dissolution? The first one is when the partners become insolvent. The meaning of insolvency is when any of the partner becomes bankrupt and he is not able to contribute any part in the business. The second one is when it is an unlawful business. On the happening of any contingency, this can include a contingency like death of a partner, expiry of term of the partnership, when the work is completed, due to for which the partnership firm was constituted, and the fourth being when a partner is declared as insolvent. Now, when a partner is declared as insolvent, this you will notice which is different from insolvency of partner where all the partners are insolvent, but here when one partner is declared as insolvent. Then the next one we notice is dissolution by court order, section 44. Here we notice when is the circumstances under which the court has to intervene. The first one, when a partner becomes of an unsound mind, when he is not able to give his best to the functioning of the partnership firm. The second one is when the partner becomes incapable of performing his duties. For example, he is met with an accident, he is handicapped, he is not able to come to the office to work. The third one is when partnership agreement is repeatedly breached by a partner. Breached when the partner works against the partnership agreement, it is called as repeatedly breached by the partner. The fourth one is when the partner is guilty of any misconduct, when the partner is not following the law of the land, the partner is doing work which is against the interest of the partnership firm. The next one is when the firm runs only at a loss for no other reason the firm is able to run repeatedly when the partners are trying to perform their duties and in spite of that when the firm runs into losses. And the fifth one is, and the sixth one rather, is when dissolution, which is justified by the court, when there is no other reason but dissolving the firm is to the benefit of everybody. So these are the modes of dissolution of partnership firm. Now let's come to the next topic, which says settlement of accounts in case of dissolution of firm, which is section 48. The following rules subject to the agreement between the partners shall be observed for settlement of accounts. The first one is treatment of losses, section 48A. Losses including deficiency of capital shall be paid off in the following manner. The first one is losses will be paid out of the profits. When the profits are insufficient, then it will be paid out of the capitals of the partners. Lastly, even if the capitals are insufficient, if necessary by the partners individually in their profit sharing ratio, which they will have to get from their private property. The second one is application of assets, section 48B. The assets of the firm, including sums contributed by the partners for deficiencies in the following manner. How are they supposed to apply for the assets? First, to pay firm's debts to the third parties. Then, the asset, whatever money has been received from the sale of assets will then be used for paying loans from the partners by the firm. Then whatever money is left over will be used to pay the capitals of the partners. After point A, point B and C, whatever is left over from the sale of assets will be called as surplus, and if there is any surplus shall be distributed among the partners in their profit sharing ratio. Now we have seen what is the meaning of dissolution, what are the modes of dissolution, how settlement of accounts take place, and now let us see what are the accounts to be prepared. The accounts to be prepared under dissolution is, the first one is realization account, then we make partners loan account, then we have partners capital account, and then we have cash or bank to make the payments and realize all that is left over. So we finish with the theory portion of dissolution. Thank you. We come to the next topic, which is difference between dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. What is the difference between dissolution of partnership and the dissolution of a firm? Now, dissolution of a partnership is only change in the agreement between the partners. The firm continues. Dissolution of partnership firm is the discontinuance of all the business activities of the firm, including the relationship between the partners. The second difference is, the books of accounts may not be closed in the dissolution of partnership. The firm continues. But in dissolution of a firm, books of accounts are necessarily closed. Dissolution of partnership is voluntary. It emerges out of an agreement. Dissolution of the firm may be voluntary and compulsory at the same time. In dissolution of partnership, there is no intervention of court. The agreement between the partnership changes when all the partners agree upon it. They only have to change their partnership deed in this. In dissolution of firm, the court intervenes if deemed necessary in the dissolution of partnership firm. Thank you.